we would not be where we are right now in cancer treatment if someone did not take a risk years ago. The reason why we have chemotherapy, the reason we have radiation therapy, treatments that you would think of as very toxic, was because someone took a risk.
Try to have a very positive attitude. We're a very research-focused clinical trial center, and really the field of oncology is changing so rapidly with new drugs available all the time that we try to incorporate the latest knowledge to try to give patients well above that perceived average of 18 months. And that's why we do clinical trials. The hope is always that we can do better, that patients will survive longer with the clinical trial treatment option.
Doctor after doctor would be on TV talking about how, well, I mean, they were basically kind of throwing their arms up, that we know there's other things other than standard of care, but we're just kind of afraid to do anything and to take that risk. He seemed to be the one person out there that was forward-thinking and that wasn't afraid to take some risks and to kind of personalize treatment to each patient instead of saying, well, this is kind of what we do, chemo and radiation.
Well, after my diagnosis, we were kind of just sifting through the weeds and trying to figure out what the heck is our next move. You know, there's so much to process. I never even heard of glioblastoma before in my life, so we're, you know, myself and then my family, my wife, everyone's just dialed in, just on it, trying to figure out, you know, what to do next. And then they're saying, our next move should be a clinical trial. Again, I didn't even know what a clinical trial was and how do we get in one. So that was their next task. You know, we're trying to just hammer it out and figure out what our next move is, you know. So basically nothing's been easy. up until now, it's just...
Actually, getting to Kesari wasn't too hard, though. Mm-hmm. I've just sent him a message on his website, and that was like Saturday night. Sunday morning, he emailed me and said, here's my cell phone, call me. And by Tuesday, we were on an airplane to California.
What's wonderful for people that find him is that he does what they call off-labeling. So he can treat them with a drug that may be meant for tuberculosis, but he knows that combination with something else, you know, might go after that tumor. And then he fights with the insurance company saying, yes, I know it's not tuberculosis, but trust me, this is gonna work. And he really fights for his patients.
With this cancer, insurance companies will only cover treatment that's FDA approved, and that is chemo and radiation.
What Dr. Kesari wants is that for everybody to have access to this kind of care. And the only way you get that is through a trial. So only if the trials, you know, are FDA approved, then everybody that treats a cancer patient, a brain cancer patient, can have access to his innovative thinking.
He does have some wild ideas, but I think he arrives at these conclusions and these ideas is because the normal protocols for treating brain cancer and some of these other cancers are not working.
So the traditional clinical trial route for getting drugs approved for brain cancer has had many failures, and not for lack of trying. There have been all sorts of chemotherapies, targeted agents, and immunotherapies tested for glioblastoma, but later on, again, after they have already received multiple lines of treatment, and none of it is working very well, not enough to want to say this is a treatment for any glioblastoma patient. So in order to make changes to something that hasn't had much success, I think Dr. Kesari tries to come at this problem from a different angle. He has to push boundaries and try something that no one else is trying. And I think that changes need to be made in how new drugs are tested in order to get better options.
Those are the kinds of people that we support. Those are the types of initiatives. They're cutting edge, they're out there, and a foundation can do everything we can to support them, both from a financial standpoint, but a leadership standpoint as well.
That as the trial proceeds and we're seeing successes, then Dr. Kesari can go to the pharmaceuticals, because each patient, the dosage is exorbitantly expensive. And Dr. Kesari fights with the insurance companies to get them to pay, but it's very, very expensive. And most patients can't afford it. So once you have the funding for the trial, you know, whether it's by pharmaceutical or by donors, then the patients don't absorb that cost. And then the insurance companies start to take notice because they see it's working.
That's normal, that's contrast going in, okay?
It'll be about $1 million to get through the whole trial. But without that seed funding, without the donors' belief in us and what Dr. Kesari can do, we wouldn't be treating Landon, and that would be a crime.
In terms of the trial goes, like, we, you know, I think I said this before, but like, we believe in Dr. Kesari and believe in what he's doing, you know, otherwise we wouldn't be here. We wouldn't have completely uprooted our lives in Maui and moved to Southern California, you know, so we do believe in it, and that's why we're here.
The hardest and the most frustrating thing I go through is knowing that I have the most brilliant researchers doing incredible work, that's all they think about, and my job is to get them the money so that they have all the tools and all the necessary things they need so that there's no barriers in their way. And that's the hardest thing in my world, that I just need more doors to open. And if they do, I have no doubts with Dr. Kesari at the helm that you're either going to live with brain cancer and you're going to live a well and productive and happy life, or he's going to cure you. And I don't know when we've ever been closer to that.
You know, without sounding corny, like, if it's something I can do here and now that's going to help the next person that's in my position, then I'm going for it, you know?